Hey Premiere Pros, it's Paul Murphy here, and today we're going to create this cool neon sign effect, and we're going to do it without any keyframing at all. Okay, so when I set out to create this effect, there was a few things that I wanted to make sure I did with it. And the first thing was, I don't want to have to keyframe that flickering effect. I don't want to have to manually go in there and adjust the opacity and keyframe that. The other thing was, I wanted to play around with some of the environmental effects. So I wanted it to have like a halo effect around it. I wanted it to cast a shadow on the wall, and I wanted the wall to sort of fall off into darkness as well. So all of these things to make it look kind of interesting and different and not have to do a lot of work to make it as well. So let's just jump straight into making this. I'm going to open up a new sequence, and this sequence is 1920 by 1080, but you could do it in any sequence you want. The first thing I'm going to do is create some new text. I'm going to go up to graphics and titles and go new layer, text, and we'll type in our text. I'm going to type neon sign. Now, the font that I'm using for this, I've actually taken from Adobe Fonts, which if you have a Creative Cloud subscription, you get for free. And I will leave a link to this font in the description below. And the font is Rick's Neon Sign Pro. It just kind of looks more like a neon sign to me. I'm going to set this to center, and I'll increase the size of it, and I'll make it all caps as well. And then I'll just make sure it's centered in the frame. And for this, what I want to do is go into the fill. And because I'm going to make this like a pink neon sign, you can make it any color you want. You can make it red or green or blue, but I'm going to go with pink. I'm going to go down here and choose the pink color, and then I'm just going to make it sort of like a pinkish white for the fill. And then I'm going to go over to the stroke, and I want the stroke for this to be like a hot pink. So I'm going to choose something from the corner down here. And for my stroke settings, I'm going to set this to 3 pixels, and I want the stroke to be coming from the center. So this is just going to create a very fine hot pink outline around the actual text. Now that we've created the text, I'm going to just jump straight into creating the flickering effect. But before I apply it to one specific letter, I'm actually going to apply it to the entire text. So to do that, I'm going to go over to my effects panel, and I'm going to get the strobe effect, and then I'm going to drag this above my sign. Now I'm going to select it in my properties panel, and then go over to my effect controls panel. And you can see here are all the default settings for the strobe effect, but I just need to change a few things here. The first thing I need to do is I need to make it so that the strobe isn't operating on the color, which means it's going to strobe to this color here. I'm going to set it to makes layer transparent. And that means that it's going to strobe its visibility on and off like this. And that's a kind of neon sign effect as well, if you wanted to apply that too. But I don't want this to go completely off when it's strobing. I actually want to see a little bit of it underneath, as though it's a tube that hasn't been lit up in a neon sign. So to do that, I'm going to blend it with the original so that it's about 10%. So we can still see a little bit of it underneath when it's turning off. But of course, the other thing here is this should look like it's a faulty tube. So it should sort of be flickering in a random way. So what I'm going to do is go into the random strobe probability, and I'm just going to turn this up to 10%. So now we have a strobe that looks like this. And now if we want to apply that to one specific letter, all we need to do is go into our properties panel. I'm going to right click my text and choose duplicate. And then I'm going to go over to the letter that I want to be flickering on and off. So in this case, I'm going to make it the O, but you can make it any letter you want. So I'll select it. I'll go over to my properties, and I want to untick the fill and untick the stroke. So now I'm actually seeing what is underneath that layer there. So which is showing me the strobe light and the neon sign going on and off. So now we very quickly have an effect like this. And we haven't had to do any keyframing for it. Now, beyond this point, I think we need to move this sign into an actual space. So we're going to put it up against a wall, and then we'll look at adding some environmental effects to it as well. But let's start with the wall first. So what I'm going to do is select all of my text layers, and I'm going to put them in their own group. So I'll click create group, and I'll call this text. And then I'm going to add a new group, and I'll call this background. And I'm going to drag this underneath the text. Now for the background, I'm using a brick wall image that I got off Adobe stock. This is just a free image, and I'll leave a link to that in the description as well if you want to use that same image. I'm just going to select it in my project panel and drag it into that group there, and I'll probably just scale this down a bit as well. Now for the lighting effect on this wall, I want it to look as though the neon sign has lit up the wall. So I'm going to do that with the tint effect. So I'll just drag this above the wall, and you can see we've got two settings here, map black 2 and map white 2. For the white, I want that to be the kind of light that this is throwing off. So I'll go and grab that hot pink. I might just make it a little redder actually and select that. And for the map black 2, I just want this to be sort of the opposite of that, but a little bit darker. So I might grab some of this dark purple up here, and that's what's going to be used for the shadows. And then I want to have like the shadows sort of fall off away from the actual light. So to do that, I'm actually going to use the lumetri effect. I'll have to scroll all the way down the bottom for this, and there's lumetri color. I'll drag that above the tint, and I'm just going to go into basic correction down to exposure, and I'm just going to turn the exposure down until this gets quite dark like that. And then to create the light effect around the actual sign, I'm going to use an effect mask for that. So I'll just go up to where it says lumetri color in my effect controls, and I'm going to create an ellipse mask, and I'll just drag this out so that it sort of covers the sign, and I'll just invert this as well, and maybe I'll just rotate it a little bit. And then for the fall off effect, I'm going to use the mask feather. So I'm going to increase the feathering effect so we have a nice fall off, and I'll also increase the expansion effect as well. So now we have something like this where it looks like the sign is actually lighting up the wall. So now I just want to add a few little environment effects to make this look a little bit more natural. So I'm going to go back over to my text group, and the first thing I want to do is create like a halo effect around the actual text itself. So I'm going to do that with the drop shadow effect, and I'll drag this above the neon sign. Now I'm going to call this glow just so I don't get confused. And over here, what I want to do is change the shadow color to that hot pink. So maybe something like that. And I want to set the distance to 0. And for the softness, I just want to turn this up until I get the feeling as though this is sort of throwing off a bit of light. So yeah, just something like that. And you can see as soon as you start to do this, this really does give the impression of a neon sign. So I feel like that effect alone sort of adds a lot to the effect here. Now, as well as adding a bit of light here, I also want this to cast a shadow onto the wall. So obviously for that, I will use the drop shadow, and I probably won't rename it this time as well. And for this, what I want to do is just increase the distance so I can see the shadow poking out from behind the neon tubes. And I'll also increase the softness as well, so this isn't so harsh. So that's just going to give us a sense of a bit of depth away from the wall there. And then the other effect I want to add here is I want the actual light, the whole light, to feel like it's kind of pulsing a little bit. And for that, I'm going to use the strobe effect again. So I'll drag this above the shadow. And what I want to do here is again, change the strobe to makes layer transparent. But I want to blend this with the original by about 90%. So there won't be much of a difference between when it's strobing on and off. And I'm also going to turn up the random probability. So I want this to be sort of moving quite unpredictably. And that just gives us like a small touch in the actual light, so it feels as though it's pulsing rather than just a static bit of text. And then the last thing I want to do, because this is a bit of light, it really shouldn't look so harsh in terms of the lines. So I'm just going to add a little bit of a blur to this. So I'm going to grab the Gaussian blur, and I'll just drag this above everything in my text group, and I'm just going to turn up the blurriness to about 3. And however much you turn this up will sort of depend on the size of your sequence. So if you're actually using a 4K sequence instead of what I'm using, which is an HD sequence, you may want to turn that up a little bit more. And that just gives us an overall effect that looks like this. And there you go, we've created a neon sign without having to do any keyframing at all. I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, please remember to like and subscribe, and maybe check out some of these other videos as well.